Hey folks, my name is Joey. I am a video team member here at test.com. And today I wanted to introduce you to a new camera that we've been playing with. This is the Zcam K1 Pro. This is kind of a unique camera in that it's a 180-degree stereoscopic camera that we've been using for testing out on the VR platform to make VR videos. You can see it's got two lenses here that help in after you stitch it in post-production, you get a 180-degree view. Now, we have been shooting a bunch of different stuff like with this camera, and it has some considerations in how it's rigged. So I wanted to kind of walk through. We'll talk more about this camera later on and its specs and what it does, but for this video, I just wanted to walk through how we rig up a camera like this, because it's not unlike rigging up a DSLR for cinema purposes or even like something like an Alexa Mini. They all kind of have a similar way in which you approach rigging it. This has some special considerations in that it's 180 degrees, which means it sees up, down, left, right. But the up, down means you can't just throw it on a tripod, as you'll see the tripod legs hanging out. So it's a little bit of problem solving. So I just kind of wanted to sit down and rig this up. We have this camera. We have the Sennheiser Ambio VR mic. This is a microphone that records in spatial audio, so that as you're turning your head while you're watching this video, the noises will be coming from the direction that they're supposed to be in. You can see it records in four channels. It's got microphones kind of set up, but it records out to four channels, which means that that's another consideration. We're gonna need something like the Zoom F8. So then we can record four channels and also taking a fifth for the lav mic that we'll be having on a subject. So with these things in mind, I'm going to grab a bunch of my bins. I have a bunch of stuff behind me, all my different camera rails, camera rigs, base plates, all set up. I'm just gonna lay out a bunch of things and see how we can rig this stuff up for a full day of production in the way that we need this camera to operate. So let's get to it. All right, here we go. Here is a bunch of stuff that I pulled from the bins, from other camera rigs, and just laid it out on the table here to try and come up with a solution for this. So let's start with kind of the way I usually always start when I'm looking at a camera to rig is the base plate. This is a tilted universal base plate. This will be kind of what is going to be in the middle of the whole rig. This is kind of built for a shoulder rig. We're not going to use this for shoulder because that's going to be crazy on VR. So it's going to pretty much stay locked into this plate, and this plate will just go right into the tripod. So let's start here. Like I said, we need to pull this camera out a little further to not see the tripod legs. So I just gathered a bunch of these 50 millimeter rails. These are pretty standard when it comes to rigging up cameras. They often will hold matte boxes or have lens support, fall of focus. A lot of things attach on to 15 millimeter rails like these. So let's put on this size. I think it's like a 12 inch or so. That'll give us some room to mount the camera on the end. Before we get to that, let's work on the back of this as well. So I got these smaller ones. These are like 4 inches or so. These will hold both the plate for the battery and also kind of act as a counterweight. You're gonna have a lot of weight sitting on the front of this thing with the camera, so we're gonna want a little bit of counterweight in the back. This is a battery plate that uses the V-mount batteries, the V-lux here, and then you get options for D-taps out, 12 volts, USB, charge your phone with that. So let's mount this guy here. And again, this is all stuff that I've used on like my GH5 rig or Blackmagic rig, just kind of repurposed for this. Let's throw a battery on there. This one battery is 95 watt hours. So you can travel with these. Anything above 100 is usually a little trickier. But we're gonna be doing some flying for testing this out. So I wanna make sure this can all fit into a carry-on. And have no problems with TSA or any of the airline requirements for that stuff. So let's think ahead. Before I put the camera on, we're gonna need to mount this Sennheiser microphone on it. Now this is some random little piece of something I have. I think it's mainly for DSLRs. You put two rails in here, mount a DSLR in the middle here, and then you have room for two rails here. We can do other things, I think. I haven't used this in a very long time, but we'll use this as our piece that will hold the microphone. I can do boom microphone or this Ambio VR mic. And it also gives us a grip here. Speaking of that, let's mount this little handle on as well. This is just a wooden handle that you can apply into a cage. So that gives you something to hold on to. Let's put this on the back of this. All right, there we go. There's That'll give us 2 points to hold on to as we move this camera around. Let's throw this Ambio mic somewhere. This is a little 15 millimeter rail that I used a like a screw joiner here and screwed on to a boom mic holder. So if we just loosen this guy, we can slide that right in there. And now this has a front. Obviously it's spatial, so it needs to know which side is forward and backwards and the such. Okay, so there we go. There is a microphone, a battery. We're gonna need to mount the F8. I'm going to use this middle base plate to hold the Zoom F8. This is where the camera would usually be mounted to, but because the F8 is so heavy, I want this to land right in the middle of the tripod. And lock it in there. All right, well, there we go. We got something happening now. We're gonna need to have a lav mic, like I said, so let's put this right on top of the Zoom. Now we can work on the camera. So the camera does have a quarter inch thread at the bottom for tripod plates, I'm assuming, but we're gonna need to put something that can take in the rails. So what I have is this little small rig rail slash, I don't know, I guess it's just for holding other accessories onto your rail. So let's go ahead and mount this on. There we go, it's starting to look like a camera somewhat. All right, there is our main rig. We're gonna need to do is start adding some power. Like I said, I wanted to power everything, so everything needs to come from this V-mount battery plate. So let's get cabling going. All right. There we have it. There is our rig. As you can see, it's much bigger than just the camera. But like I said, we need this audio gear attached on. We do need to power all this stuff. So let me kind of run through the power lines here. We got D-taps coming out of the V-mount. We got one D-tap going into the power supply for the Zoom F8. We have the USB that I talked about earlier powering this lav mic, and then we have D-taps coming out of the plate here powering the Zcam K1 Pro. Now this whole, this one battery here will probably last us all day long. I can just do a full charge on one and have it on set, pretty much turning on at the start of the day, turning off at the end of the day. I'll probably travel with a few of these just to, as a precautionary measure, but I trust this battery to be running all this stuff for the whole remainder of the shoot. And then as far as cable management goes, it could probably be a little cleaner. Have just everything bongo tied onto the rails itself to stay out of the way. Here's our little handles for moving this around. We take it off the camera, take it off the tripod with the universal, or with the quick release and the universal plate, set it to the side, get our, set it down in the footprint we need. And then we do a lot of tape measuring to figure out the distances there. There you go. There is a production-ready Zcam K1 Pro with spatial audio, ready to capture some VR video for our testing. And again, this is not unlike how you would rig up other cinema cameras. This is very similar to how I have some of my shoulder cam cinema stuff for the GH5, just with the camera pulled in, a map box put at the end. All this stuff is, it's very universal when it comes to rigging cameras. When you have a shoot, you kind of, you have to see what you need and then build your camera rig based off of that to make a suitable rig that will work all day long for your production. There you guys go. I know it's a little bit of a different kind of video, but thank you for watching us put together this camera rig. We'll have more on this Zcam K1 Pro and maybe this audio microphone as well, and probably this whole setup. We'll do much more once we've done testing the VR stuff. We will have a little more to talk about. Until then, I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. I better go get shooting. Thanks. Bye.
Hey everybody, Norm here. Got an update for you for that video you just watched. Since Joey put together that camera rig, he and I have actually been traveling across the United States, visiting makers and filming them in VR 180 video. We've documented the spaces they work in, their projects, their build processes, telling their stories in an 8-part series that we partnered with Oculus to launch in what we're calling Tested VR. It's available to download and watch today for free on the Oculus Quest and Oculus Go headsets. We'd love for you to check it out and let us know what you think. And Joey's gonna follow up with more thoughts about that production process in the future. Hope you enjoy and see you in the headset. Bye.